media seminam, Mekasayan, so Yemashu Sepram, and yes, so to your when I was so to your ghost right, and then I'm here, and then I am to my fellow.
High spirit, so they can't kill it. God's plan, no man fit to cancel it.
Hiplife to us is what peanut butter is to bread.
This is what actually defines us as Ghanaians.
Every Ghanaian everywhere is representing Ghana with Hiplife.
I would not even have fathomed being a musician if Hiplife didn't happen. This story of Hiplife is important to tell.
Walk around in the Philippines with the Philistines. Them dust in any vicinity, I fulfill a dream. No, I'm not a rapper, I'm an ideas company.
To understand the rising global influence of African music, you have to understand the story of Hiplife.
When I did what I did, I tagged it. So when a dude put a piece of meat between two bread and he called it a burger, he named it. And that's what I did. I named it Hiplife.
Hiplife music is a conversation between Ghana's past and its present. This is the story of a music genre that burst a global movement. But before Hiplife, there was Highlife. From Ghana's independence in 1957 through to the 1970s, Highlife was the nation's soundtrack.
Back in the what we call the colonial days, they were using all these instruments for military songs. You know, pam patam, pam patam, pam pam, pa 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 pam, pam patam. Then you know, then people were marching and things like that. The colonial masters in their bow ties, they thought that that was a high form of life, and they call it highlife.
Highlife isn't originally from Ghana. Highlife was brought to Ghana by soldiers from the West Indies that the British brought to fight the locals. Ghanaian rhythms were pushed into the highlife. We take what is happening outside and we bring our own.
I am the originator. That's what I say, Gyedu-Blay Ambolley is the tree. Those that came later, they are the branches. Because when we were children, we didn't have money to buy congas. So we started using our mouth for rhythms.
The country in the world that has the richest tradition of orators and linguists is Ghana. The king of the Ashantis cannot speak to anybody. He can only speak through a linguist.
The linguist is the rapper. But it was me who added rhythm.
For the next two decades, highlife artists infused global beats like reggae, jazz, funk, and disco into the genre.
The rap, the jazz, everything is, it's just like you're cooking a soup. You need to have the right ingredients in it for the soup to become tasty.
In 1992, after 11 years of military rule, Ghana had a new constitution and democratic freedom. Young Ghanaians flooded the cultural capital, Accra. American hip-hop dominated the newly liberated airwaves. A young music producer, Panjianov, tapped into that scene.
I recorded a demo for almost every single rap group I could find in Accra at the time, free of charge. The first person I wanted to work with is my childhood friend, Reggie Rockstone.
My name is Reggie Rockstone, the Hiplife originator.
Reggie is always hype, all the time. And when he speaks, it's like he's rapping. I mean, he's literally, his language is like poetry.
I grew up in Collindale, UK, Brixton, Crackney. They call it Hackney. I grew up in Brooklyn, New York, Flatbush. Coming back home to Ghana. 93-94. When I got off that plane, the smell, the sunshine, the love, right up till we started this movement called Hiplife.
Things took off when Reggie met DJ Rab in Accra.
I met Reggie Rockstone in a nightclub called Miracle Mirage, and he was rapping on the mic.
Rab was an African-American who came to Ghana to stay for a long period and helped develop this sound that became Hiplife.
And I introduced myself. Now, Reggie had these short locks at the time, and he was with another rap artist called Freddie Funkstone. And I thought I was listening to rappers from Brooklyn. So immediately, I got up out of the table. I said, look, I don't have any discs, but I can make beats. We left the club like 4 in the morning. We got to the recording studio like 10 or 11 in the morning. That like a few hours later, everything just started clicking.
Rab was very much like Reggie as well. Two peas in a pod, both very excitable people. So when they're around you, you know, you need to prepare for them.
I need you to open up. Open up means use this floor here.
If he was here, he'd probably be sitting right next to me. My best friend, my manager, my business partner, my advisor, everything.
1, 2. I wanna tell you what we are. Hey! Come to camera.
This shot is very special. Reason is, it's dedicated to my brother, DJ Rab. That's who's on these T-shirts.
Unfortunately, he passed away. But yeah, Rab was Reggie's partner in music for a long time.
The two Ghanaians raised in the West mixed hip-hop with Highlife, and Hiplife was born.
I looked like the folk that they have seen on MTV. I had the short dress, the white beater, the Timbs, the camouflage. But then when I rapped, it was in Creep. And that just blew everybody's mind.
T being one of the biggest local languages, it was unique in a sense that nobody had attempted to put rap together in that context before.
Pops would always say, listen, Reggie, you know, all your raps, bitty, 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 people ain't got time to listen to all them lyrics there. We need something to catch them, a hook, a chorus. And he was right. Because at the time, not long before I came, Naughty by Nature had blown up with Hip Hop Ray. Oh, and my father always used to say how African that was, call and response. Now, Troll Boy, I could say that anywhere in Ghana and I get a response. Troll Boy actually is the heave ho. Anytime we have to move something heavy, it's that sound, and this tells you how powerful sound is. Besides the walls of Jericho that got broke down by the trumpets. When you pushing something heavy, you need the vim. He. So we go, cho boy. And on the yay, we're pushing yay.
Reggie Rockstone quickly became Ghana's first superstar.
It was so easy for Africa to embrace hip hop. It comes from us. Everything about hip hop is African. Right down to the boogie, right down to the swag, everything. It's only because of that big bad boat ride called slavery is how we got divided. I got an uncle that looked just like Puff Daddy. Yo, sometimes I sit back and try to reminisce. Sure, it's like a sulfur dazzy, we all miss. Do I make myself clear, G? Do I make myself clear?
Do you know who's in the back? Rockstone, do you know who's in the back? Rockstone, do you know who's in the back? Rockstone, yeah, this is the set out there. We're gonna do the slide. Africa represent.
M.anifest 94, a Pan-African cultural festival aimed at bringing Africans around the globe together, would catapult Hiplife.
I felt M.anifest was, in many ways, the perfect opportunity for Hiplife to go beyond Accra.
All of a sudden, it changed. It's like, hold on a second. These kids have something.
For the next two decades, Hiplife acts dominated West African airwaves, reclaiming hip-hop as African.
There were some huge, huge sales made by Hiplife artists like Tic Tac or Bravo, Lord Kenya. For the very first time, they became the songs that you hear in the bars and the clubs, you know, everywhere. Then when I came to this country, I shot the very first Hiplife videos, which was Reggie Rockstone, Joe Boy, and Talking Drums adding.
I'm about to flow,
cause he's rhyming with the O.
One set of Afro, but now some cornrup. Pinky, yes, I'm pinky.
I had wasted a lot of money taking Talking Drums to America and thinking that in 1995, America was ready for a Burna Boy. They were rapping, but they were wearing these batakaris. 30 years ago, were considered to be very primitive, traditional clothes. But I went to Atlantic in 1995 with Talking Drums. I shouldn't have done it. Because I met record executives who couldn't even conceive that there was hip-hop in Africa. So it took till 2020 for an American label like Atlantic to sign Burna Boy.
By the late 2010s, Afrobeats out of Nigeria, a hybrid of Highlife and global beats, had knocked Hiplife off its pedestal. Afrobeats became the catch-all for West African pop.
You want to miss the right, I miss the right now.
Hiplife is dead because the driving force of the music is the younger people, and the younger people do not identify with Hiplife.
I'd be a fool to sit on BBC and say Hiplife is dead. No, Hiplife is not dead. I do you wrong.
Ghana and Nigeria, sibling rivals on everything from jollof rice to football, dispute whether Afrobeats was born out of Hiplife.
I get embarrassed when I see these unnecessary Ghanaian resentment towards Nigerians because of their success. It's not a good look. I don't deserve all your awesome, but truthfully. We benefit from Nigerian success, as Nigerians do benefit from Ghanaian success.
Some young people now don't realize the collaborations and work that has been going on between Ghanaian and Nigerian artists for the last 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 years. Nobody will understand the importance of Hiplife until Afrobeats is the biggest music in the world. We are almost there already. But without Hiplife, there would be no Afrobeats.
Ghana had established that sound before Nigerians really got into the stride of things. For them, 99 was like a watershed moment for them. And 99, Ghanaians already had megastar Hiplife artists. If you were to take the music that they were doing and compare it to what was happening in Ghana, what you'd find is that it was more like the pre-Hiplife American imitation sort of music, and it didn't have an identity. But as time went on, they fused in the pidgin, the local language, just like Hiplife did.
Nigeria carried the torch, but Ghana lit the torch.
We dropped the soul. We should have stood by that brand, because our cousins next door did the same thing with Afrobeat, and they did not budge. And here we are today. You see, they baking the cake now. We begging for a slice.
We live in La Vida Loca, in a Noka, up and down in Gotham streets, yeah, I'm a joker. So many people peeping, wanna hold ya. You giving them silent treatment, no disclosure. I fell in love with a Cinderella, a chocolate chick tastes like Nutella. She know the hair, what can I tell her?
Let's be clear first and foremost. Afrobeats is not Nigerian, it's Ghanaian and Nigerian. The originators of Hiplife were a bit too precious about what it should be. So as new versions sonically were happening, you could hear people saying, oh, this Jama, this Azonto is watered down. It's not real, this thing. There's always the idea of real. That you have to evolve or perish is what any music form has to understand. Those that were gatekeeping hip life were refusing to acknowledge the evolution. And the thing must evolve. The thing must evolve. For it to survive, the thing must evolve.
Now, a new generation of artists raised on Hiplife are writing its next chapter. KiDi and Kuami Eugene are the fresh faces selling out international shows and captivating a global audience.
I learned almost everything I know from the street. How to survive with no money in the pocket. There are a lot of songs made by Hiplife artists that actually motivated me, kept pushing me to go. I could see people making ends meet from doing music, which is Hiplife music. And I knew I had a space in there. My vibe, die by fire. My vibe, oh, die. Afrobeat is making people enough money and it has the public eye. My vibe. Even though we have artists doing Afrobeat, it doesn't tell our story. Hiplife is what tells our story. And I think it won't be fair for us to lose such a thing. That means we are losing part of our heritage. Hiplife is the illustration of the culture of Ghana.
I'm so tired, I don't know what to do. Dreams, dreams, dreams.
So I mix my highlife, what I will hear locally from my legends, with R&B, what I would hear from the West. When you're cooking, you throw in this, and then about 5 minutes, you throw in this. That's what happened to the Hiplife genre. So when it came, it was in its pure state. Like, you know, keep your eyes on the road. Like, it came in its original form, but with time, certain artists took it, took something out of it, added something else, and it became like, oh yeah, Hiplife has changed now. Reggie Rockstone, a name that will forever be remembered in Ghanaian music history, also came and said, okay, this is what we're doing, you know. It's our fathers are having fun with this. What can I bring? What can I spice it up with to give it a little different flavor from what our people know? And that's what birthed Hiplife. We had now Hiplife and we had Highlife. We had two things now. Now the question is, where do we go from here? Select some honey, buy some Prada, Gucci, Louis V, Giorgio Armani. My mama needs a host, my brother needs some shoes. I had to get the family right before I lost my granny. I'm from the ghettos of a shy man. In a male-dominated industry, rapper Eno Barony is changing the face of hip life.
I think the existence of people like Eno Barony is the breaking of the glass ceiling moment. Yeah, I remember the first time I was on the radio station with her. When I saw her, she out-rapped me. I was like, my goodness, who is this one? All I remember was just being shocked when she started rapping. I was shocked. I just wanted to listen to her. I was like, who is this? Watch out this year who sent me a drip yet to me kaka show flow kim this time back to not a stone. I don't wanna be a god MC who can punish a kin for his sins for Kanta.
I wanna be someone you can never be. I'm the king of queens. Who name me crew and we a matter? I'm as deep as you can go.
My name Eno means mother in my native language, Chi. And that's the name my dad gave to me. And somehow, some way, divine intervention, I'm like the mother of rap in Ghana.
This is the birth of a new era, freaking and on magic cycleta. We're taking the game to a different dimension to forget to wakata. Gone are the days, and then man fata, you share be drama on my yankasa. Yeah, I'll be sleeping on women for too long, still I'm on yankata. Say what da, see when yeah, cause I give life to the game.
If I'm the mother of rap, Miss Boy is like the grandmother.
Miss Bell shot to fame in 2007 with a groundbreaking Hiplife album, 16 Years.
Every girl I knew at that time was dressing like Miss Bell. It was a pleated short skirt with a crop top and a little jungle bag. Miss Bell's songs were the number one songs played on the streets because all the girls were dancing to RB16 Years. When I came in the music scene, I never saw girls my size. Most of the girls I was seeing were, let me say, skinnier. People were talking about my image so much. Why are you like this? Why are you not going to look like this and stuff? So it was bothering me. When I accepted myself as who I am, I did a song called Heavy Load. And I realized, oh, so I have fans who are just like me and are looking up to me, the way I dress, everything I do.
The truth about why there are not many women involved in Hiplife and in the music space is that, I mean, the space, unfortunately, is still quite sexist, you know. It's difficult for a woman, you know, to operate in these spaces, whether even in as simple as midnight sessions in a studio. Every successful music scene in the world has a lot of women in it. So if we want to succeed, bring the girl down.
So if you see a woman doing anything male dominated, you don't doubt it.
One of the oldest African proverbs, which is Sankofa. There's something beautiful in the past. If you think you can't go forward without it, go back, pick it up, and take it with you into the future.
That is where we are now, in the moment in Ghanaian music, where we would need to revisit what that brilliant culture called Hiplife, that birth, a lot of what's happening now, to really reimagine it and see how we move forward.
Sister, damn, I miss you. I'm going to November, I'll be back to get you.
We are at a Sankofa moment with Hiplife.
It's all that counts, can I count on you too? I'm begging you, let me fly free and make some revenue. If I chop, you go chop some too. 12 months pregnant, this idea is long overdue.
Hiplife's place in the future of global music may come down to who it lets in, what it holds on to, and whether it can evolve.
Scratch my back, it's all up. They fix my itch, it's all up. Symbiosis, they benefits. Them no go fit. When you they scratch my back, it's all up. If you they fix my itch, it's all up. Symbiosis, they benefit. Do for each other.
Perhaps the only question is, what do we choose to evolve? Do we choose to evolve what is closest to us? Or do we choose to evolve the elements that are foreign to us? You cannot be American, don't waste your time trying. You can't be Jamaican, don't waste your time trying. Who are you? You are Ghanaian. So just be Ghanaian.
Right now, if I go to the UK and I play any African music, it doesn't matter what it is, it will be branded Afrobeats. As long as they know it's an African artist, it's coming from South Africa, it's coming from Senegal, it's coming from Kenya, it's coming from Nigeria, they'll just call it Afrobeats. That's the problem. The problem isn't the fact that Hiplife has lost its ID. Hiplife hasn't lost its ID locally.
It is how the international audience is viewing Hiplife.
Cross my T's and dots my eyes. Stress way day my chest I ostracized. Do I treat you man rubber till you smell the ties? Me and I dream be a yaka, I'm cotton ties. My jalabia tailor made all customized. My English straight pigeon all bastardized. What I for do? Ignore the bastard guys. I work, they snore, I pass those guys.
Hiplife is still giving birth to artists day in, day out. If it's lost, it won't bear fruit.
We have our heritage being rooted in it. And it is something that we can't let go. Of course, it's part and parcel of us.
I want Hiplife to be that good story that lifted black folks in Africa and all over the world, gave young people a voice.
My generation, it gave us a voice from Africa. Initially, it was just in Accra, then it was Ghana, then it went to West Africa. Now it's global, and through Nigeria and Ghana, we have artists featuring with Beyonce, featuring with Justin Bieber. Ultimately, I believe that as a musical genre, it gave a generation a voice and continues to do that. And this voice has and is slowly changing the perception of this continent.
Hiplife is identity to us.
Identity is very important. If you lose that identity, then you know where you belong to. The mother is Highlife, but rap is Africa. 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 Weather forecast a bit nippy ahead. Beggars can't choose but be picky instead. 9 to 5 blues, kick me, I'm dead. Driving in a storm, I fit see ahead. Weather forecast a bit nippy ahead. Beggars can't choose but be picky instead. 9 to 5 blues, kick me, I'm dead. I barely no sleep, give me some wavy. Boys I bread all week, give me some wavy. Boys are living no be cheap, give me some wavy. But thank God it's Friday, baby Jimmy.